something really weird happened. It's the trooper, or as the children say, we out here. What the hell does that mean anyway? If not for finding myself with a wild hair up my ass, I never would have tried this wrong way driver. I never would have tried this club's coffee. What is it? Brown sugar, oat milk, shaken. Espresso action. It's Tuesday, back over here at Aria, looking for a poker game. I'm on the list, got the coffee action going. What is the situation over here? It's Tuesday. Some people might say the slowest day for poker on the strip. I'm trying to look at Bravo, but my phone's been a little bitch. I said it. Speaking of my phone and Twitter, since I was speaking of Twitter just last night, Elon offers to buy Twitter for his original offer price. What do you think of that? Think Elon's gonna buy Twitter? Maybe if Elon buys Twitter, I can get my account back, since I didn't break any rules in the first place. Some subhuman piece of garbage tweeted his phone number at me publicly in a threat. And all I did was retweet it. I get suspended. The piece of subhuman garbage probably didn't. The only thing I miss about my Twitter account is the fact that it said joined 2008. It's like I'm one of the OGs on Twitter. I've had my Twitter account since 2008, yo. Why didn't you suspend the douchebag who was constantly tweeting me about my dick? That's right, my dick. Aria has 5-1-3 games, 3-1-2 PLO games, 3-2-5 games, 2-5-5 PLO with a rock, and so on and so forth. Not a lot going on today, just me, coffee, and a poker game. I ate at home. It's healthier, it's cheaper. 3 eggs, a little bit of white cheddar on top, slap them between 2 pieces of Dave's killer bread. My game at Aria tonight was two things. Number one, pretty damn good. Number two, kind of exciting because something really weird happened. In hindsight, well, here's the thing. I don't know where to start the story. Should I start the story and just tell you the story? Or should I tell you the caveats first? Should I tell you the things I realized later first? I'll tell you the story first. As soon as I sit down in the game, you have to notice that they're opening to 20. Multiple players, different players opening to 20. So that's already a good sign. It's 1-3. I sit down with the 300. I don't know, I think I have about 260 or something to start this hand. It folds to me. We were playing five-handed at the moment. Two people were walking, one guy got up and left before, I mean like two hands after I sat down. And so I get dealt ace-8. I am under the gun plus one. I make it 15 with ace-8. The button calls 15. We see the flop. You know what, I'm gonna be honest. I don't know if we saw the flop heads up or three ways. If it was three ways, the small blind was in there. The flop was 8 high, like 8-5 deuce or something like that. I let out for 20. The button called. If there was a third guy in, he folded. I don't even remember that part. Because something happened in this hand that would make you kind of forget if there was another guy involved. The turn card is an ace. I now have top two. I lead for 25. The button calls. So the river card is another 8. I have $75 in my hand, $100 behind it. Maybe I had a little less to start this hand. Whatever, I had $100 and like, what's happening? How are you? Thanks a lot, man. So but there's a nickel there. So I grab the nickel and bet the $80, leaving that even 100 stack. So the dude's tanking, he's thinking about it. The guy honestly did not tank for that long, but I guess he felt like he was tanking. This is something else that I think I may have realized later, like an hour later or something like that. And I think that what I realized later will explain why he did what he did. Actually, why he did several things that he did. But the guy grabbed $2 and tossed them over the line. Well, as soon as he did that, I grabbed my cards and proceeded to immediately, but not overly quickly, table my hand. He sees my hand and then immediately says that he was tipping the dealer, that those $2 were for the dealer. I was like, don't even try it. This is not your first time playing poker. Don't even try it. I was like, you are not getting away with that. And I was just like, call the floor. So he again said that he thought he was taking time, and so he was tipping the dealer for the time or whatever. And I was like, but he didn't say a word when he picked up two $1 chips and tossed them across the line. He never said a word. I was like, well, you should say that first. So when I told the dealer to call the floor and she pressed the button to call the floor, the guy really didn't argue beyond that point. He just picked up a black chip. He had like 300 in the game. He just picked up a black chip and tossed it in the middle of the table my direction. I grabbed 20 out of my $80 bet and tossed it to him, and the dealer pushed me the pot. At the time, I was absolutely certain that this guy was making a move, that he did this on purpose to get me to show my hand. Because I feel like he had enough time to stop me from showing my hand. It all happened quickly, but I don't think it was that quickly. You can't toss money. This is why I really don't like the one chip calling with an undersized chip. If it's an oversized chip, I get it. If I bet $80 and the guy throws a black chip across the line to indicate a call, I'm perfectly fine with that being the rule and the procedure and like the flow of the game. But these people that throw a $1 chip over the line to indicate a call, I think that if they press the issue, they could find their way out of paying some of the calls that they make. Because I have seen some situations where a guy throws in a nickel or a quarter to indicate a call and then say he didn't realize how much the bet was, and then they just let him off for the amount of money he threw over the line. I have seen that happen. I've seen it in tournaments and I've seen it in cash. I absolutely vehemently disagree with the one chip to indicate a call when the one chip is lower than the bet. I don't like it. But it's SOP all over the Vegas Strip. It is standard operating procedure. It goes on every second, every day. As I'm saying this, five different people threw in one chip to indicate a call all across the Strip. So when the guy threw $2 over the line, I tabled my hand. He didn't say anything. I didn't see him gesture to the dealer. Nothing like that happened. He just picked up $2 in the middle of tanking and tossed them across the line. Yes, in the direction of the dealer, but the guy is in seat four. The pot is in the direction of the dealer. The pot is between the dealer and himself. So I got pretty hot because I felt like the guy was trying to angle me. Pretty much all angles, there's a rule to cover it. I believe wholeheartedly if the floor came over, the floor would rule in my favor. Well, you threw money across the line, that indicates a call. I really feel that way, but here's what I figured out later. I actually think the guy is a dealer at Aria. Not 100% sure. I knew I had seen his face before when I sat down because I remember faces, but I think he might be a dealer. Maybe he's not a dealer there. I have no idea. But the dealer who he was supposedly tipping because he was taking time did come up and speak to him two times after that during the session. So I don't know if they know each other. I don't know if they're like, I don't know. Maybe he is a dealer. And if he's a dealer, that would explain two things. Number one, it would explain why you would tip a dealer in the middle of tanking, especially when it wasn't that long. And it would probably also explain the reason he didn't want the floor coming over. He didn't want any trouble. He just wanted to pay. He just wanted to pay the bet and move on. He said something, though, that got me a little heated because I really don't like it when someone tells me to not talk about something or to be quiet or something like that. My immediate response in every situation is, I'll say what I want. Especially when I wasn't saying anything except, like, that may have worked on, there was a guy walking and I was like, that may have worked on that guy, but it's not working on me. I was still convinced that this was like a ridiculous move or whatever. Whether it was a move or not a move, the guy threw money across the line when the action was on him in a manner which indicates a call all day, every day in Vegas, and I subsequently turned over my hand, which is exactly what I'm supposed to do. So at the end of the day, I'm in the right. He has to pay me the $80. So, at first I thought I was being cheated or someone was trying to cheat me. I mean, think about it. You could do that whenever you want. You could toss a dollar towards the dealer, hoping the guy turns over his hand. But if the dealer's perception is that you're tipping the dealer, they don't care what the guy who made the bet's perception is. No one cares what my perception is. Get it? So that's a move you could easily make. Tip the dealer to try to get the guy to prematurely turn his hand over. I don't know. Actually, to counter it, I thought of what I should have done. But I thought about it too late because I have never seen this situation happen before. I have never been in a situation where a guy tips the dealer while I'm waiting for him to call me. But here's what I thought about, and the next time this happens, if it ever happens again, I'm gonna do exactly what I'm about to tell you. The guy tosses the money over the line towards the dealer, and then I will immediately say, good call. And then uncap my cards and move my cards forward slightly face down in an attempt to get the guy to say, whoa, I wasn't calling, that was a tip to the dealer, I raise all in. That's exactly what I'll do next time. That's what I should have done this time, but I didn't think of it because I'm not sitting at the table actively trying to think of how to re-angle someone. But honestly, that probably would have worked if I had known he was tossing money to the dealer, if I knew that, I would have said, good call, uncap my cards, tried to induce him to bluff all in. At which point, I say, I call. If someone throws money across the line in a manner which always indicates a call, and then tries to say they didn't call, you're not getting away with that, not against me. You're not getting away with it, not against me. Whether the guy intended to do it or whether he didn't intend to do it, whether he knows who I am or whether he doesn't know who I am, I never know who knows who I am. Everyone doesn't know who I am. Some people know who I am and they dislike me. Some people know who I am and they think I'm a joke and they keep it to themselves and whatever. So that $80 didn't have a lot to do with the entire session. I end up winning $476. That's what happened. So was I cheated? Well, I wasn't cheated in that I lost anything. I cheated myself by not re-angling, which I should have done, which would have been completely and totally in bounds, in line, because you're certainly allowed to lie out loud during a poker hand about your holding or anything like that. And when you say good call, while there's still action, and you know there's still action, and you pretend you don't know there's still action, perfectly in bounds. I found it very interesting. Let me know what you think. Did the guy purposely try to cheat me? I mean, in light of this Garrett, Robbie, Hustler, Casino fiasco that has gripped the poker world over the past few days, I don't know. Maybe so. Maybe they tried to get me. Even if they tried to get me, they didn't get me. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. I'm gonna see you next time. That goes for all these people too. I'm gonna see you next time.